This video is sponsored by Skillshare. In this video, we are going to create a 3D looking golden text animation inside of After Effects in a few simple steps. You can use this animation for any video editing project, especially for wedding. So this is Vikash from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's get started. Alright, so if you are new here, be sure to hit the subscribe button for more interesting videos, and let's take a new composition and get started. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is gonna be our main composition. So I'm gonna call it gold text. Set the size of this composition maybe 1920 by 1080. You can go with 4K as well, and we have to set a frame rate. So in this case, I am using 30 frames per second, which is a normal frame rate, but if you want a smooth animation, then you can go with 60 frames per second as well. And we have to set the duration of this composition maybe 10 seconds long and hit OK. And now we have to create a text over here. So select this text tool and go to this character. If you can't see this character, then go to window and check this option character. And here we have to select a font style. So in this case, I am using this Gloss and Bloom font style, color pure white. Hit OK, and I'm gonna set the size of this text maybe 220 pixel, and click over here and type anything that you want. After that, we have to align this text in the center. So just go to paragraph and click on this option center text. If you can't see this paragraph, then go to window and check this option paragraph right over here, and just go to alignment, and I'm going to align this text in the center of this frame. So click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically as well. And after that, just select this move tool, select this text layer, right click on that, click on this pre-compose, and this is going to be text composition. So I'm going to call it text comp. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. Now we have to create text reveal kind of a effect. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer, and let's call it noise. Hit OK. Now just go to effect and preset and search for fractal noise. So this is our fractal noise effect. Let's apply this fractal noise effect on this noise solid layer. And here we have to do some basic setting. So just go to fractal type and change this basic to dynamic twist. We have to set this contrast value something around 150. Open this transform and let's increase the scale value. So I'm gonna set this value 150 maybe. And after that, open this sub setting, and here we have this sub scaling. So I'm gonna set this value maybe 85. And we will get this type of output. And now we have to animate this evaluation. So to animate this evaluation, we have to use an expression. So I'm gonna use time expression. So hold Alt on the keyboard and click on this stopwatch button. And here, this is the expression box. So I'm gonna type time multiply by 50. Alright, and after that we will get this type of output, as you can see. Now close this layer, close this fractal noise effect as well, and now we have to create a duplicate of this noise layer. So hit Ctrl D to duplicate, select this top layer, and here we have this option invert. So check this option invert, and now select both the layers. Right click on that, click on this pre-compose, check this option move all attributes into the new composition, let's call it noise, hit OK. Now I'm going to use this noise animation for this text. So turn off the visibility of this noise and select this text composition, just go to effect and preset and search for CC image wipe. So this is our CC image wipe. Let's apply this on text composition. Select this text composition, go to effect control, open this gradient and go to layer and change this text composition to noise. All right, and just go to on 4 seconds right over here. And let's animate this completion. So click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on completion. Go to very first frame of this animation and set this completion value maybe 100. And now we will get this type of text reveal effect, as you can see. Alright, and now select both the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose and make it a separate composition. So check this option, move all attributes, and let's call it text reveal. Hit OK. You can remove this text reveal composition from here. Now we have to import a reflection image. So just go to this project window, right click on that, click on import file. And I'm going to use this HDR reflection image, and I have given a link in the description. So just go to the link in the description and download this HDR reflection and import this into After Effects. Before we proceed further, let me tell you, this video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creatives where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes for creatives and curious people on the topic, including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and more. Skillshare offers creative classes designed for real life and all the circumstances that comes with it. These lessons can help you to stay inspired, express yourself, and introduce you to a community of millions. You can check out this course, Animating with Ease in After Effects on Skillshare by Jack Bartlett. This class is for anyone looking to take control of the look and feel of their motion design. Whether you have using After Effects for a year or you have only just started learning the program, Skillshare is very affordable for everyone. It's less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. And the best thing is that the first 1000 people to use the link given in the description will get a free trial of a Skillshare premium membership. Just go to the link in the description and check this out. Now, just drag this HDR into this gold text. Hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Let's scale it up and set this value something around 175%. Close this layer. And after that, just right click on this reflection image. Click on pre-compose. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition. Let's call it reflection. I'm going to call it reflection composition. Hit OK. Now let's animate this reflection. So just go to effect and preset and search for motion tile. So this is our motion tile effect. Let's apply this motion tile on this reflection composition and just go to very first frame of this animation. Set this value something around -200. And click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on tile center. Go to the end of this animation and I'm going to set this value something around 500. And we will get this type of animation, as you can see. And you can check this option mirror edges as well. And after that, let's apply same reveal effect on this reflection as well. So just go to this project window. Let's import noise into this gold text composition right over here. Turn off the visibility of this noise. Select this reflection composition. Go to effect and preset and search for CC image wipe. Let's apply this CC image wipe on this reflection composition as well. And open this gradient. Select this layer noise and go to on for second right over here. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on completion. Go to very first frame of this animation and set this completion value 100%. Now we will get this type of reveal effect for this reflection as well, as you can see. Alright, and after that, just select both the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose, check this option, move all attributes into the new composition. Let's call it reflection reveal. Hit OK. Now just go to project window and let's import text reveal into this gold text composition and turn off the visibility of this text reveal. Alright, now select this reflection reveal. go to effect and preset and search for CC glass. Let's apply this CC glass on this reflection reveal. Open this surface and here go to this bump map and set this text reveal. Go to property, set it to red channel, and let's down the softness value and set it 5. Let's increase the height value and set it 50. Open this light section and change this light to point light. Now close the CC glass and let's apply one more effect. So I'm gonna apply CC blob lights. Let's apply this CC blob lights on this reflection reveal and open this blob lights. Go to blob layer and set it to text reveal. Go to property and set it to alpha. Go to softness and set this softness value maybe 6. Set this cut away value maybe 30. You can set it to auto for faster render view. And we will get this type of text reveal as you can see. Now let's make it gold text. So we have to take a new adjustment layer. So just go to layer, go to new, take a new adjustment layer. Right click on that, click on rename, call it color. Select this color layer, go to effect and preset and search for curves. Let's apply these curves on this color. Go to red channel. Let's increase the red saturation just like this. Go to blue. Let's down the blue saturation and set it like this. And finally, we will get this golden text. All right. Now let's apply one more thing. Just go to effect and preset and search for hue. Let's apply this hue and saturation on this color layer. And let's down the master saturation value and set it to negative 25. It's looking more realistic as you can see. All right. And after that, select all the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose. Let's call it final composition. Hit OK. Now let's animate the text. So just go to very first frame of this animation, select this layer, hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on a scale. Go to the end of this animation and set this value something around 90%. And now we have the zoom out effect as you can see. All right, now let's apply this golden text on a background. So just go to project window. Let's import any background. So I'm gonna use this particle background, click on import. You can download this background from link given in the description. Now let's import these particles into this composition. And we have to increase the red saturation a little bit more. So just select this one, go to effect and preset and search for curves. Let's apply these curves on this background. Go to red channel. Let's increase the red saturation a little bit. And it's looking much more interesting as you can see. And after that, we have to create a shadow kind of a effect right over here. So let's take a new solid layer, set it to pure black, call it black, hit OK. Now just drag this black below this final composition, go to this mask tool and select this ellipse tool. Let's create an ellipse and open this mask. Let's increase the mask feather something around 300% and close this layer, select this one, hit T on the keyboard and set the opacity maybe 30%. Turn off the outline and finally it's looking much more interesting as you can see. Now close this layer and now just go to on 1 second and let's create deep to black effect. So just select this one, the background layer, hit T on the keyboard to open this opacity. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe. Go to very first frame of this animation, set it to 0%. Go to the end of this animation, maybe on 9 seconds. Click on this diamond button to create a keyframe. Go to the end of this animation and set this opacity maybe 0%. And let's do the same thing for this text. So let's go to on 9 seconds. Select this final composition, hit D on the keyboard. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on opacity. Go to the end of this animation and set this value maybe 0%. All right, and finally we will get dip to black effect. Now close this layer and it's almost done. Go to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon to get notified when I will upload my new video. My name is Vikas and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.